you've been here at least 5 times in your life. Good for you. Some things never change. Keep a smile on your face, good feeling in your heart. That's all that we ask you to do. We're going to get right to the business of this program tonight. You know, over the years, well, first of all, I share with you that we have the luxury of having the celebrated Freedom Riders out of Colorado with us. And over the years, we've offered credits and salutes to our military, even the branches of the military. We have also offered a salute to the courageous people who survived the 9/11 attack. We've talked about our children, the future of America, and you know what? It all equates to freedom in our land. We know also that it all began with our Native Americans. Specifically tonight, we salute the Chickasaw Nation. It's in the music. It is in the flags. It is in the ride. And this is the way it begins.
I was born, hurling on one frosty morn, look away in the rain, look away in the rain. Star-spangled banner, yeah.
rodeos, freestyle bullfights. As we've told you repeatedly, it is the best kept secret in the entertainment world. And you folks are one of the reasons why. We have waiting in the wings 15 of the finest young bullfighters in America. We have, once again, the powerful fighting bull staff from the Coyote Hills Company, Rex Dunn and family. They've got the mainliners here tonight. You know how important you are to the encouragement of these bullfighters. So with that thought in mind, let's open the gate and meet them. What do you say? We have the luxury of having six gold buckles here tonight, and they belong to four individuals that we would like you to meet. Coming into the spotlight is one of the finest young men in our game. He has developed into one of the best bullfighters on the Pro Rodeo Tour. Say hello to the 04-06 world champion, Wasim Mansour. Talk about a bullfighter that has a great fan base. It all started back in the late 90s. 99, he got just a touch, a chip of the diamond. He came back in 2007 to get the rest of it. Two-time world champion Andy Burrell, Arkham, Oklahoma. This guy comes from Alabama, and he shows up on his mind. In 2008, it developed for him from Muscle Shoals, Alabama, Ross Hill. It was just this past October that when the chips were down, it was the championship battles we ever had in the history of this game. They mobbed him and congratulated him, and so did you. He is the reigning world champion, and he's from Wayne, Oklahoma. Now, as you know, we have introduced these guys to you previously. They are two of the greatest bullfighters we've ever seen in this game, and they will evaluate the fights here tonight. They will be giving their opinion of what they see by these guys, and they are our official pro officials. I want you to meet a man that has the respect of everyone that ever put on grease paint and baggy pants. We've seen him at the national finals time after time after time. From Bridgeport, Texas, the amazing John Brogan. We'll bring the lights up just a little bit so you can see exactly how this discussion's gonna go. You wonder about the qualification of these guys? We gave you their credentials. We know what they can do. We know what they have done, what they may be able to do yet. So the thought crossed our mind, what if they were to give us a little example of the bullfight before we started all this? What do you guys think about this, John? What do you think? He said, I'm out of here. Well, I'll tell you one thing. We do have one of our judges that has not gone crazy yet. Brogan said, I'm out of here. That's a bad idea. I don't don't know where you're. What about you, Lance? Huh? What do you want to say? You ready to mix out? You better let him know a little bit more. Bring him on. Give me one. What? He's not kidding around, is he? He means it. Do we have a body bullet if we do? Oh, oh, yeah. It is no easy deal, not by any means. I will tell you while we have just a moment, and if I had Lance or John up here, they could probably give you a little better description of it. But I know so many times the fans will say, how do they judge it? How do they evaluate it? Well, think about a couple of things like this. If a bullfighter will play a real good game in front of the bull, perhaps if he will do a step through, maybe a reverse, he may go in and get a hold of the bull if the bull is looking like it's going to leave. So basically, here's what happens. It's like a football game, only you play both sides of the ball. I can tell you, these bullfighters would rather play defense any day, but you may have to shift from defense to offense, and you may have to do that in just a time period where you would snap your fingers. Speaking of which, I see one of our two, Merrillmen. You talk about guys that play an important part of this game. You talk about a couple of guys that have been proud favorites here and still are. Winesboro, Texas, Cameron Keaton is right out there in the barrel. Say hello to him, will you? You know him. You already know him. And where is your old partner? He's over here back at the gate somewhere, isn't he? Andy North always has a smile on his face. He is from Yukon, Oklahoma. And how many of you folks live in Oklahoma? To happen. The bull is loaded. He has only one horn. I have talked to bullfighters about why that is such a detriment, and it is actually pretty complicated. Those bulls have a blank side. They can curl their head around a little tighter. So about the time you think you've made the turn and got under their sights, no way. They will hunt you down. I bet you, the Jess Pranks is smiling over here, thinking about that too. Like crooked nose, baby, huh? Here we go. Yeah. That is old one horn Brindle. That's what they call him. Well, it wasn't too hard to take him. He's only got one horn and he's there. Hey, there was a step there. That's what we were talking about a moment ago. Thank you. for the man named Tyler. That's another good celebration. I know we have a whole host of airmen and some of our friends that graced this event for years, and right over here to my left. They have to be thinking about position. They have to be thinking about how Cameron feels right now. So he takes the barrel hop and gets out of it. Opening round. Check the scores coming in for you now. Rich K, your on-air favorite, is here tonight and will be making the presentation a little bit later on. The score comes up like this. 36 on one side, 39 on the other. That will be a 75-point bull fight for Matt Myers. And the young man Aaron Hargo maintains his lead with the 84. And here comes the veteran that we talked about, the consistent winner. He has seen him win round after round after round here. Made the short round, or finals if you will. The fast October, that's going to be it, man. Look at the move. You got kind of a feeling of what you're seeing here tonight?
Hey, I'm glad to be here. I'm glad to get away from my wife.
what she do to you.
That's Bernie Lee, I tell you what, we driving down the interstate the other day, come to the big billboard.
Yeah.
This good looking woman in a bikini, drinking a Coors beer.
Yeah.
She punched me and she said, do you think if I drank that, I'd look like that? I said, I don't know about that, but give me about two cases of it, you sure would. Okay. She didn't like it at all.
No.
And all of a sudden, boom, here come the police.
Oh, yeah.
Pull me over.
Right.
Come up here and he said, son, you know why? Well, he didn't say son. He said, mister.
So the guy wasn't blind, right?
Yeah. He said, you know why I stopped you? I said, no. He said, you were speeding. I said, man, I wasn't speeding. I was going 70 miles an hour. Of course, old Bartley said, no, you wasn't. I told you, he's going 85 miles an hour. I said, for crying out loud. He said, also, I'm going to have to, what are you going to have to do to me? Give you a ticket for a cell belt.
Seatbelt. That thing that goes across the seat. Yeah.
I said, sir, I just took it off before you walked up there. You know what Bernie said?
What?
No, you didn't. You don't never wear a seatbelt. Oh, I told you. I said, for crying out loud. I just got fed up. I said, will you shut up? Well, he walked around to her side and he says, honey, does he always talk to you like that? She said, no, sir, only when he's drinking.
That's really good.
So you know where I spent the night, don't you?
Yeah, I know.
Well, she wanted to come up here, but I wouldn't bring her.
Why?
Well, anyhow, I went to the bathroom the other day. There she was. She just got out of the shower. She got on that scale. She said, look at me. I'm ugly. I'm fat. I'm wrinkled. She said, give me a good compliment. I said, well, you ain't sure got 20/20 vision. I tell you, I gotta get out of here before she shows up.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about it for Mr. Rick Young? You will get used to it. You will get used to it. I can tell you that for sure. He is a fun dude. Hey, I do want to remind you, and all of the boat pilots for that matter, tomorrow from noon until 2 o'clock, some of the stars that you see right here tonight will be signing autographs at the Laser Zone Family Fun Center. You know that it has been, continues to be, one of the highlights of the weekend. Thank you to Leah Robinson for providing that for us once again, and it's a nice place to take the family and all of the kids to out meet some of the bullfighters. Speaking of which, it is time to go to the Flowers Oil Company round number 2. So here comes Steve Warren. He has the chips in hand. We will draw from the bullfighting order. And those are a bad bunch of cats that are coming in. Did you check the gate here, Steve? Just to make sure that that thing's not going to be open? Okay. Here is a young man that it has been so much fun to see some of these guys start their career right here in this arena. And then guys like Benji and I have the luxury of seeing them at major rodeos, one after another, as they have developed into the great protection staff that we have in professional competition. That mold happens to fit this young man. He is from the little community of Meteetse, Wyoming. Dusty Tuckness is here again tonight. Alright, here comes the draw. Number one, he will be our leadoff man in round number 2. From the panhandle of Oklahoma, out near the town of Guymon, which hosts one of the large PRCA rodeos of the year, we'd like you to welcome Mr. Brian Flanders. He is a newcomer to our game, certainly not to the game of bullfighting. Number 3 will be his position. Number 3 for Brian. Now, we will go to a guy that you've seen time after time, and boy, is he solid. He is like a rock. Terry Stone, Ben Winter, Texas, back again. He will be automatically in the number 2 position. We got the bulls lined up now. If you could see all the things that are taking place right back here in this back pins, both these bulls, you would have the same respect for the Dunn family that we all do. what we acknowledged him a while ago. I bet he'll smile at you if you say hello to him. Andy North, Yukon, Oklahoma, is there. Got a new haircut, didn't you? Oh, you did. Trimmed it right off. Let's start. We'll lead this off. You wonder about things that have happened to young men like this? He was one of the designated bullfighters at the Wrangler National Finals this past year. He has already completed 30-some performances in Fort Worth, among other rodeos, and his season has only begun. You see that bull trying to get out? His body did it, does he? Huh? Yes, he said, break. Break. I'm ready. Trying to dig your grave right now. And it's scare any deep enough. Waiting in the wings. Typically, we will wait a round or two and perhaps three fight back. Now we do have the score that was awarded, Brian, and we'll share that with you, 63 points. But if he does take three fights, then we will not, he will not be looking at that score as not either or. You have to make your decision. He'll throw the score away and take the bull. I would imagine that's exactly what he'll do. If and when we have that confirmed, we will share that with you. If I might return to the subject once again of Laser Zone, they have a whole host of folks here tonight with a whole group of gifts for you. Who would like to have a little souvenir of this event? How about a little football? Oh man, we've got a whole load of them, don't we? Yeah, we do. Here. he's an awfully good bull fighter. That is without a question. But what is the opinion lead-off man? He says it is the lead-off. He's not worried about that. He'll be all right. You know that. Next, we go to the man from Muscle Shoals, Alabama. This is Josh Lathan. So he draws the number three position, is that correct, Steve? All right, thank you. From Duncan, Oklahoma, the big tall guy. I bet a lot of you know before I even mention his name, by that description, exactly who he is. Dave Yancey, great guy, great athlete, and he will occupy the number two spot. Now, the Bulls are not in the shoot right now. Don't be concerned about that. We're going to be all right. You know, Benji, we were testing this audience a moment ago, and maybe we gave them an uphill climb. I have a feeling that on the Friday night that we have a lot of folks that are just dying to get involved and sing a little. Huh? How many? That's right. We'll give you a shot. I think they're ready for the day out now. They didn't do it more than a little while ago, but we've got them all limbered up. You want to try that again? Huh? Let's see. See there? Thank you. If you're having a good time, to give them a cue there.
It's party time!
It's party time. You are right about that. You are right about that. Okay, Bulls are in. We are ready to go. And our lead-off man, one of the in-house favorites, Andy Burrell. Now it's interesting to see how the bullfighter will set up from the first bull. Wow. Came out of that pretty good. You know that? He knew what to do to recover. 82 points, Andy. Nice play, bud.
I'm going to shoot, baby.
Davionce, Duncan, Oklahoma. Now you see? See on that video? You see him walking up there talking to camera. Big smile on his face. Didn't seem to be concerned about anything. Some of these guys will stand dead still, let the bull come right to them. Just depend on the move of the bull. Make their counteract move late. All day long. Others will do like he did. Oh man, that bull got a horn inside his shirt. And if not meant for that, he had made a good escape of that. He has scored separately. 75 is the score for Dave. He knows that he's a little disappointed. Wasn't in his plan at all.
Be happy.
Right.